The 8051 has four important ports: port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3. These ports allow the microcontroller to connect with the outside world. The four ports of 8051 microcontrollers have certain specific functions and corresponding features. In this video, we will take a gander at the purpose of each of these ports. Before getting into the detailed discussion on the four ports of 8051, let us first know what are all the features of the four ports of 8051. Each port has 8 pins. Thus, four ports jointly comprise 32 pins. All ports are bidirectional and they are constructed with a D-type output latch. They have output drivers and input buffers. We can modify their functions using software and hardware that they connected to. All the ports are configured as input ports on reset. And to configure port as an input port, one must be returned to the port. To configure it as an output port, zero must be returned to it. Let us discuss about port zero, its features and functions. Port 0's address is 80H. The construction of port 0. Port 0 has a D-type latch, unidirectional buffer and two FETs at each pins. It does not have an internal pull-up resistor. An external pull-up resistor is needed when port 0 is defined as an output port. Port 0 of 8051 has two main functions. One is to be used as simple input-output port and to access external memory in conjunction with port 2. Let us discuss the functions of port 0. Simple I/O port. When we use port 0 as an input port, the internal latch should know that it is being used for input and thus a digital 1, that is FFH, is returned at port address of 80H. This turns off the transistor, causing the pin to float in high impedance state, connecting it to the input buffer. We can read data from read pin data or read latch bit. When we use port 0 as output port, the latch programmed at 0 will turn on. Consequently, the FET will connect to the ground. We will require an external pull-up resistor of 10 kilo ohms here to give a logical 1 for using port 0 as output port. When the 8051 wants to access external memory, the address for the memory generates due to port 0 and port 2. We get the lower half of the address from port 0 and upper half from port 2. This is done using ALE pull-ups, which helps to latch the address to the external bus. Once done, the port 0 goes back to being an input port to read data from the memory. Let us discuss about the port 0 function in detail. First, we will discuss about port 0 as an input port. When port 0 is used as an input port, one has to be written on the latch of port 0, and one more important thing is that the control signal to be 0. Control signal to be equal to 0. Input-output operation, and it should be equal to 1 for external memory access. Coming back, one on the latch and zero on the control signal, and we enable this latch, the data is available on the output as a 1, and this Q bar is equal to 0, and this is a 2:1 max. And when control signal is 0, it allows output of latch to pass through it. Since FET gets a 0,
here it is the control signal is equal to 0, so the NAND gets both the inputs as 0, right? So 0 0 0. Since the FET, both the FETs get the input as 0, both are of open circuiter, then output allows anything to pass through it. If you measure the output at this point, it is in high impedance state. It is in high impedance state. It is either in 0 or in 1 state, that is, it is in third state, that is high impedance state. Now port 0 is ready to act as an input port. Suppose if we connect a ADC or a keyboard at this particular port 0, then it will act as an input port. Suppose if it wants to write, since it is an input port, it is going to write something over it. If it wants to write a 0 over here, it will overwrite on the high input impedance state, and that particular 0 is being read through this read pin. The same time, if we want to write a 1 over here, that particular 1 is being overwritten on the high impedance state, and that particular 1 is also being read through this read pin or through this buffer, right? This is how the port 0 acts as a input port. I will summarize it again. In order to act port 0 as an input port, a 1 has to be loaded onto the latch, and if we enable the latch, and in order to act as an input or output port, the control signal should be equal to 0. So by making the control signal is equal to 0 and placing a 1 to the latch, giving a 1 input to the latch and enabling the latch, makes the output of latch to be 1 and 0, right? So since this 0 is being given to a MUX, why we have connected MUX over here is this port 0 can act as an input output port as well as external memory for accessing external memory. So in order to make the dual function, a multiplexer is being connected over here, right? So while it is being acting as an input port, a 0 is being coming over here, it is being multiplexed. So this 0, and here already the control signal is equal to 0 in order to act as an input output port. So we will be getting a 0 and 0 at the FET input. Since 0 is being obtained for the FET, both the FETs are being open circuited, and if you measure a voltage across this point will be in high impedance state, that is, it won't get a 0 or it won't get a 1 input, that is, it won't be of a low out or it won't be of a high out. It will be in the third state, that is high impedance state. So now the port 0 is ready for acting as an input port. Suppose if an analog to digital converter or a keyboard is being connected to this port 0, and if the keyboard or analog to digital converter wants to give something to the port, that is, since it is acting as an input port, what it will do is, suppose if it want to write a 0, if it wants to give an input as a 0, it is going to overwrite on the high input high impedance state. Right, the 0 is being overwritten on the high impedance state, and that 0 is being read through this read pin or through this buffer. The same if the keyboard or analog to digital converter wants to give a 1 as an input, so it is going to again rewrite on the high impedance state, and that 1 is being read through this buffer. Let us discuss about how to configure port 0 as output port. We want to configure port 0 as output port, we have to write a 0 to the latch, and if we enable the latch, we will get a 0 at Q, and Q bar is equal to 1. And as I have told, when the port 0 is acting as an input output port, the control signal must be equal to 0. So here we will be getting a 1 over here through this 2:1 max, and we'll be getting a 0 at this FET. So this particular FET is going to act as an open switch, and this is going to act as a closed switch. When we measure the voltage at this particular point, this will be equal to 0. So at this instant of time, the port 0 will act as an output. That is, it is going to send some data to the external device. Suppose if you want to write a 1, that is, I have to get a 1 at the output of port 0, means what I will be doing is that I will be writing a 1 over here. Let me erase this and I will show the things. So now what I am going to do is I want to get an output of 1 over here. If I want to get an output of 1 over here, I'll be writing a 1 over here. If I write a 1 over here, I'll be getting Q is equal to 0. Q is equal to 1 and Q bar is equal to 0. Since I am getting 0 over here, so I'll be getting a 0 over here, which is being passed through this 2:1 max. Already the control signal is of 0, so 0, 0, here it is of 0. So if I measure the output and voltage at this particular point, as we have seen in the input port section, it will be in high impedance state. It will be in high impedance state. But I'm supposed to get a 1 over here. Since I have given a 1 over here and I want to send this 1 to the output section, I'm supposed to get a 1 over here. Instead of getting a 1, I'm getting a high impedance state. How to avoid this is by means of connecting a pull-up resistor. If we connect this pull-up resistor over here, what this resistor will do is it will pull up the value of this point to VCC. So it will pull up the value of this point to VCC. So what it is being called as pull up resistors. So now we got a 1 over here, right? Since VCC is being pulled up and it is being obtained at this particular point, a 1 is being obtained here. So we will be getting a 1 at the output section. Suppose if we are writing a 0, right? If we are writing a 0 over here, right? We are writing a 0 over here, I'll be obtaining 0 here and 1 here. So this mux will be getting a throwing a 1 to this FET, and this will be of 0, right? And this particular point I'm going to get a 0 only. So this pull up resistor, what it is going to do is it is going to pull up the high impedance state to PCC. It is not going to make the 0 to VCC, right? Clear with this? When it is being in the third state, that is in the high impedance state, at that point only this pull up resistor will make this point, or it will pull this point's voltage to VCC. when we are getting a zero over here, it won't do anything. This is how the port 0 acts as a output port. Now let us see how the port 0 act as an external memory. While it is acting as an external memory, I have told that the control signal must be equal to 1, and this address bar data will be equal to, we can apply 1 or 0. Let us start with 1. If we apply a 1 over here, so 1 with 1, or both inputs are of 1 for the NAND gate, and we'll be receiving a 1 over here. And since we have an inverter over here, it will be of 0. So a 0 is being passed through this 2:1 mux. We will be getting a 0 over here, right? So this switch FET gets a 1 over here, and this has a 0 over here. And if we measure the output at this particular point, you'll be getting a 1, right? Suppose if I want to write a 0, then so now I am going to write a 0 over here. So I'll be getting a 1 over here and here, and 0, 1 is being nothing but of the input to this NAND. So I'll be getting a 0 here, and the output at this particular point is 0. This is how the port 0 acts as an external memory.
Let us discuss about the features and functions of port 1. The address of port 1 is 90H. Port 1 has 1 D latch, 2 unidirectional buffers, 1 FET, and 1 internal pull-up resistor at each pin. It has only one function to act as an input-output port. When port 1 is functioning in the capacity of input port, a digital 1, that is FFH, is returned to the latch at 90H. This turns off the transistor and the pin floats in high impedance state. Consequently, it connects to the input buffer. When port 1 is functioning in the capacity of an output port, the latch is given as low signal, that is 00H. This turns the field effect transistor to 0. The pull-up resistor is off and the port is used as an output port.
Now let us see how the port 1 functions as input-output port. Port 1 does not have any dual operation, so it has only input and output operation, hence no need of multiplexer over here. So in port 0 we had multiplexer at this particular point. It is this particular point we had a multiplexer. This multiplexer is used to multiplex the input-output operation as well as the external memory operation. So in port 0 we had a mux over here. Since port 1 is going to act only as input-output port, no need of mux over here. Suppose if we want to act this port 1 as an input port, we'll be writing a 1 over here, and if this latch is being enabled, we'll be getting an out of 1 at this latch, and the complement of Q, that is 0, is being obtained here. Since 0 is being applied to this FET, we'll be getting a open circuit at this particular point. And if we measure the voltage at this point, it will be in the third stage, that is, it will be in high impedance state. It is in high impedance stage. So in order to bring it to state 1, a pull-up resistor is being connected over here, which pulls up the voltage at this point to VCC. right? So this is how it is going to act as a input port. Suppose if, as we took an example of connecting a ADC or keyboard, if a keyboard or ADC is being connected over here, what it will what it is going to do is it is going to override this high impedance state, and the data is being read through this buffer. Okay, now let us see how this port 1 is going to act as a output port. In order to show the operation of output port of the port 1, I will erase these things, right? Now if we want to act as an output port, we are writing a zero over here. If we write a zero over here, and if this latch is being enabled, we'll be getting a zero out at this Q point, Q at the output of Q, and a complement of it one at Q bar, and this particular FET act as a closed switch. That is, everything is being grounded, right? So we'll be getting a zero over here. Now if we want to send a zero or one over here, this is nothing but of the state. If you want to apply if you want to get a one at this particular point, you write a one over here, you'll be getting a one here and its complement zero at Q0. Since a zero is being applied to this FET and this is of open, so it will act as a open switch. Since it is being acting as a open switch, you'll be getting a high impedance over here, a high impedance over here, and that is being replaced by means of this pull-up resistors. This pull-up resistor, it will pull up the voltage at this point to VCC, that is equal to 1. So we'll be receiving a 1 over here, right? This is how port 1 is acting as an input output port.
Let us now discuss about the features and functions of port 2. The address of port 2 is 10HH. It consists of a D-type latch, one FET, an internal pull-up resistors, two unidirectional buffers, and a control logic block. Its main functions are kind of similar to those of port 0. It can be used as an input-output port and can access external memory in conjunction with port 0. As we see the function of port 2, it can act as an I/O port and it also acts as a memory access. When it is being acting as an I/O port, it is quite similar to port 0. The only difference here is that in port 2, we use one FET with an internal pull-up resistor instead of two FETs as we saw in port 0. When it is being in memory access, port 2 is used in conjunction with port 0 to generate the upper address of external memory location that need to be accessed. However, one key difference is that it does not need to be turned round and get a 1 in the latch immediately for input as in port 0. It can remain stable.
Let us discuss about the port 2's function in detail. The port 2 can function as input output port as well as external memory access, as similar to that of port 0. Port 2's input output operation is much similar to that of port 0's input output operation. Let us discuss about the external memory operation. 8051 has 4 kilobytes of RAM. Right, so if we feel that we want to connect an external ROM, then the next question is to how to access this external ROM. So we can access this external ROM through this port 2. That is, port 0 will provide the lower order address, that is A0 to A17, will be provided by port 0, and this port 2 will provide the higher order address A8 to A15. So along with this port 0 and port 2, I can access a 16 bit of address, right? Let us now discuss about the port 3 operation. The port 3 can operate as input port as well as output port. In order to act as an input port, A1 has to be written onto the latch, and if it is want to act as an output port, A0 has to be written to the latch. Its function is much similar to that of port 1's operation, right? In addition to this input output port operation, the port 3 has some other special operations. That is, the port 3 8 pins can be used as some other alternate pins in associated with the special function registers. Port 3 0 and first pin, these two pins are being used as serial data in and serial data out in along with the serial buffer of special function register, right? And similarly, the port pin 2 and port pin 3 are being used as external interrupt 0 and external interrupt 1 along with the special function registers TCON. And pin 4 and 5 are being used as timer 0 input and timer external timer 0 and external timer input pins along with timer module of SFR. And pin number 6 and 7 are being used as external memory write and external memory read. So all the 8 pins are being used as some alternate functioning pins along with the SFR. What to read, latch or buffer? If you look at the diagram of all the ports, you will see that each port has input buffer and latches. Bringing up the question of which instruction read the latch and which read the buffer, a list of instruction which read the input buffer are being shown here. We will be discussing about the instruction set in the preceding classes, but now here I am just mentioning which are all the instruction which reads the input buffer and which reads the input latch. The table shown here lists some of the instructions which reads the input buffer. And the table shown here gives all the instructions which reads the value from the latch of the port. These instructions are known as read modify instructions, as they read the value from the latch and then changes those values immediately.